Welcome back to our 1,000-yard project rifle build. Now, if you're watching this video, you're probably one of the hardcore people that's been watching this series from the beginning. Now, if not, you can subscribe to the Social Regressive up here to get instant updates, like us on Facebook to see behind-the-scenes stuff, and then down here, this playlist is going to have everything in it. Now, for those of you that are watching this video, I gotta tell you, this probably isn't the most scintillating unless you're just a little bit nerdy. Although it can be quite controversial for those of you that this does interest. Whatever I choose today is going to be wrong in the minds of probably 98% of you, and I'm going to receive lots of comments down below on why I'm wrong. And you're right. You're totally right. I was wrong. It may seem late in the game to be discussing the chambering of this rifle since, well, I already bought the rifle and it's already chambered. But actually, this was the first thing that I was thinking about. I picked the cartridge out before I even selected the rifle. With our budget, we don't have the option to swap in an aftermarket barrel. We're going to have to stick with whatever these rifles come chambered in. Now, we had those four rifles to choose from. There's the Savage Axis, the Mossberg Patriot, Ruger American, and the Remington 783. And here's a master list of all the cartridges that these rifles come chambered for. 223 Remington, 22-250 Remington, 243 Winchester, 6.5 Creedmoor, 7mm 08 Remington, 308 Winchester, 2506 Remington, 270 Winchester, 30-06 Springfield, 7mm Remington Magnum, 300 Winchester Magnum, 338 Winchester Magnum, and then the 375 Ruger. The rounds toward the extreme edges of this scale are going to be easy to throw out, but as I start throwing things out more toward the middle, I know I'll be stepping on some toes. So what the heck, let's get to stepping. Let's start by throwing out varmint cartridges. First on the chopping block, 223 Remington. A very fine varmint cartridge, but the projectiles are too light and easily blown around by the wind. Also on the chopping block, 22-250. Despite the extra powder charge, this one just won't work, mostly because the rifles that are chambered for 22-250 in this class, they all have a twist rate that really only handles very, very lightweight bullets. It's going to like those 35s, 45s, up to 55s, and really if you get much past that, it's not going to stabilize them anymore. I wouldn't mind doing a 600-yard match with 22-250, especially if I could get some of the heavier bullets like 75s or 80s, but that's just not an option. Next up, and I'm sad to let this one go, because this is my favorite cartridge right here, 243 Winchester. This is my desert island round right here. If I could pick one round that I could shoot for the rest of my life, I'd take 243 Winchester. It's so flexible, great for killing small animals, great for medium-sized animals like deer, very light recoil, easy to reload, parts are pretty inexpensive, it doesn't eat that much powder. Great, great cartridge. It's a barrel burner, and again, we're getting into the same problem that we did with 22-250. The rifles that are in this class are going to be set up to handle bullets that are about 100 grains and lower. The twist rate just really isn't there. If I was going to be shooting 243 in these matches, I would really want a twist rate that would allow me to shoot 115 grain projectiles. 105s or 107s would be pretty good. But again, I think that we can do something that can outclass this. I'm going to go ahead and throw out the 25-06 Remington. It pretty well falls into this same category. Yes, it's going to have higher muzzle velocities, and yes, we will be able to get heavier bullets for it. But one of the big problems with the 25 caliber rifles is that there really aren't that many bullets to choose from. I'm very eager to discard the heavy magnums for several reasons. First, reloading those things or buying ammunition, that would drive me into the poorhouse. The bullets are very expensive, brass is very expensive, it eats a lot of powder, and really all you get in return is just very harsh recoil. 375 Ruger, no way. I once spent an afternoon shooting 21 rounds of 300 Weatherby Magnum from a prone position, which is how I'll be shooting these competitions, and I was bruised in the shoulder for about 2 weeks. It was brutal. It was a sporter weight barrel, just like we're going to get with this Axis, and it was a plastic stock, but even though we're going to be having a slightly heavier stock, no thank you. I do not want a heavy Magnum. I know that 300 Winchester Magnum is a great sniper's round, very effective, and that the ballistics are excellent, but I'm afraid I have to put it into this heavy magnums category. I'm going to get rid of this one. I'm not really looking forward to shooting 60 rounds back-to-back of an unbraked 300 Win Mag, because that's the way these competitions go. You may not have a muzzle break, and your score be counted. And they kind of shuck you off way off to the side if you want to shoot anything with a silencer or a muzzle break. So, no, I'm going to skip this one. Now, 7mm Remington Magnum, I find this one pretty interesting. I'm going to give this one immunity. It has excellent ballistics, the recoil is going to be considerably less than a 300 Win Mag, and the projectiles are pretty fantastic that you can get for it. So we'll just jump over this and we'll go to the granddaddy, 30-06 Springfield. I'm going to remove this one from the list because, yes, it is a very capable cartridge, but again, it's kind of expensive to reload for me. The brass can be kind of expensive, and you really don't get that much more performance than you would out of a 308. Now we're coming back to 7mm Magnum, and I'm afraid that I'm removing it from the list. This one kind of hurts because the ballistics on this round are so good. There are many, many projectiles out there that have very high ballistic coefficients. Muzzle velocities, of course, are going to be very high. As far as ballistics go, this one is probably my favorite. This one is really nice. But I start getting into those magnum problems where the heat is going to heat up the barrel much, much faster than a short action round would. And with our little sporter weight barrels, they're going to get whippy really fast, and those groups are going to start opening up. So I want something with a smaller powder charge. I want something that doesn't neck down quite so much, because when you start doing that, you start getting a lot of throat erosion, and the barrel starts to degrade pretty quickly. So, sorry, but bye-bye 7mm Magnum. In my mind, the remaining four cartridges occupy the sweet spot in this group. None of them are going to offer very wicked recoil. Reloading is going to be somewhat inexpensive. They're not going to eat a lot of powder. And the ballistics on all of them are very good. Assuming pretty standard muzzle velocities using heavy for caliber bullets in these rounds, let's take a look at some projected ballistics to figure out which one of these we should go with. The winner as far as drop goes in a 1,000-yard range is 270 Winchester, followed up by 6.5 Creedmoor, 7mm 08, and then finally 308. But here's where the plot thickens. I'm not actually very concerned about bullet drop. A flat trajectory is paramount where distances are unknown, but I know this distance. All I have to do is aim a little higher with the heavier rounds. What I am mostly concerned about is the wind. Assuming a full value 10 mph wind, which cartridge drifts less? 6.5 Creedmoor takes first place, followed by 7mm 08, 270 Winchester, and then finally 308 Winchester. With these wind deviations in mind, which chamber did I choose? Okay, so why 308 Winchester? First off, when I purchased this rifle, the 6.5 Creedmoor hadn't even been announced yet. And my second choice, 7mm 08, that one just didn't go on sale. The 308 Winchester, on the other hand, was a very nice price over at Academy. And we're going to cheat just a little bit, because I already have a 7mm 08 barrel that came on a cheaper rifle. So in a way, we're actually going to cheat just a little bit, but we're actually going to cheat in a positive direction. We're actually going to save a little bit of money using a 7mm 08 barrel that came off the old Savage budget rifle, the Stevens 200. It might seem dumb to swap out an inexpensive barrel for an even cheaper barrel, but wait until you see what this thing can do. I've been shooting this barrel for a while, and this thing is predictably able to shoot half MOA groups as long as I do the reloading right. And that's what I'll be doing to get an edge in this competition. I'm not going to be shooting any factory ammunition. I'm going to be shooting some good hand-loaded ammunition with some very nice bullets. Be sure to subscribe to the Social Regressive so you don't miss any of the upcoming videos. We'll be doing that aforementioned barrel swap. And we'll be turning 308 Winchester brass into 7mm 08, which is a lengthy process, but it's pretty interesting if you're the nerdy type.